Hiya, this is Joe, aka DJ Zeph Taylor, and I'm just reporting on behalf of Pull the Party DJ, who's currently part of the Control Freak scheme with Pioneer. So here we've got our DDJ-S1 that they've given us for 2 weeks, and I'm just going to make a couple of videos on the controller, and we'll have a look at some of its features.
Right then, we'll start off with an overview of the controller. So currently you're looking at the back left of the unit, from where I'm stood. So just here it says DC in, so that's your power input, so power lead into that one there. And hopefully if we use this on and off switch here, currently set to off, and we switch it on, everything lights up and we are away. Just next to that one, got our USB port, so that's basically how you're connecting the controller to your computer. So that's what makes the whole software work, basically, with the Serato Itch.
So if we now work our way over to the right side of the controller,
here you have your minimum and maximum volume for the auxiliary in. So your auxiliary in's here, and basically into that you can plug any sort of external audio device. So I've got my iPod here, might plug that in there and run background music. Might plug the iPad in, use the sampler software on there, get some laser beams and air horns coming out of it. And then, so that one is your volume controls for it. If you come over to this side, you've got your master out 2. So here are your outputs. That one's obviously going to lead off to your amplifier, but if you want to run it off just the smaller phonos, you can do that as well.
So we're now looking at the front left of the controller. As you can see, in terms of headphone ports, you've got 2. So on the day that you forget your adapter for your headphones, it's all right, there's no problems, because... where's my headphone lead gone? Standard size, goes into your iPod, goes into your iPad, goes in wherever, also fits into here. So your headphones can still be used, so that's good news. So now you're looking at the front right of the controller. We've got 2 bits here. So this one is your mic auxiliary through. So basically it's an on-off switch, and when it's switched on, the sound that you've plugged into, well, either this microphone input or your auxiliary in at the back, which we looked at earlier, if it's on, the sound will go straight through and you can't use your equalizer or anything like that. Switch it to off and your EQ controls up here will work, and you can basically modify the sound a bit. You're now looking at the top left of deck 1. So here you've got your main microphone input, this switch here, which has 3 options. You've got off on the left, on in the center, and talk over on the right. So talk over is just that feature that brings down the music for you automatically whilst you're speaking to the microphone, saves you having to use your volume sliders. If you come along one more, you've got your volume controls of your microphone, nice dial, and then here you've got your EQ for your mic input, so your low, your mid and your highs. Very similar on the right hand deck, however over there, instead of using the second microphone, you can use the auxiliary in that we've looked at already.